A company called Global Partnership Schools, launched by two former superintendents, believe it has the tools to fix a failing school, in this case, Garrison Middle.
It's hard to notice the changes from the outside, but it's become clear that Garrison Middle School is in the midst of a transformation. Even though work crews have spent the summer doing renovations, the changes aren't just cosmetic. There's a new principal, staff, and teachers, some of whom chose to return to help with the turnaround.
I just have a love for the subject area that I teach. I'm a social studies teacher, and I love children, and I want to see them achieve.
Be out there, use that space. That to me is a huge investment.
Plus, Global Partnership school officials have pledged to come alongside staff and students to try and make lasting improvements.
I think you can come in and say, well, let's just wipe it all clean and start again. We're not doing that. We're looking at, you know, what worked and maintaining what worked, but also looking at what can be done differently, what can be done more effectively, how can resources be allocated more effectively.
Garrison's new principal is no stranger to Baltimore City. The Western High School graduate says she's ready for her assignment.
Of course, learning will continue to take place. We're still following the state curriculum. The thing that's different is that we have more resources. We have kind of more hands in the pot. And because I'm a very collaborative leader, I don't mind having additional resources and additional people to help put our heads together.
And parents say they're willing to give the new company and its concept a try.
The person that recommended this school from the Department of Education, she spoke highly of the program and support team here. So I'm hoping that they can help.
For starters, to help maintain discipline, improve student attendance, and boost test scores.
Now, the New York-based company has a three-year contract with Baltimore City Schools. Live in the 11 Newsroom, Tim Tootin, WBAL-TV 11 News.